swag walk. When you see people walk onto the stage with confidence and with style, I think that we sometimes focus on what is happening with the body versus how to actually control the body and truly swag it out. Here's an example of what I see a lot when people are trying to overstyle their walk, you know, and arms are swinging overboard, and that's where all the focus goes.
Your mind is connected to your arms, your hips are not going to get the love, right? But your arms will naturally flow if you give your hips the love that they need. You put your mind right here, you know what I mean? And then the arms will just flow naturally. You know, they're just going to flow. The subtleness of your arms will be way more, you know, way better than if you're trying to do something with your arms. So let the arms just flow, focus on your hips.
Just remember, as soon as you walk on that stage, you want to sell it, sell it, sell it. It's your job to walk on that stage and connect with the judges and have your own personal swag that steals the show and gets their attention. Now take a look and see if you can pick up on something. So I am grading this on a scale of yes to not so much. And I want you to try to pick up on why that is. As your mind can only connect to so many things at once, by focusing on your midsection and your hips, the rest of your body just flows along for the ride. Whereas if your mind goes to all of your limbs, your hips actually don't get as much of that beautiful flow and you don't have as much of that swag. So we definitely want to maintain control in the center and hold that strong all the way through. And the byproduct of control is that you're going to flow and have a very natural swag. Unlike, of course, if you're too spastic and moving your arms, your hips just are not gonna get the love that they need. So when you take it to the stage, just focus on the judges, focus on harnessing your energy in the middle of your body, let the hips do the talking, and let the arms follow suit.